Hello guys, welcome back to the YouTube channel of The Concept Guy, and today we will see some questions of Azeotropy 2020, that is this year, and it is an event organized by IIT Bombay, Indian Institute of Technology Bombay. So here what we have is some questions related to chemical engineering simulation. So our first question of 14 marks is this: there's a rate versus concentration data given to us. So rate at different concentrations is given for a reaction A to B. What we need to do is that based on the data, we have to propose a model for the rate of the form this. Okay, so this is our model, suppose we get that. So what we need to do is we need to estimate the K1 and K2 values. Okay, so we have already seen that we can actually plot these values in the MS Excel file, and we can actually trace out a curve and a trend line. And according to that trend line, we can actually find the slope and intercept. So this is the function. What we can really do direct is that we can actually take the function into MATLAB and solve it directly rather than converting it to a straight line equation form. So today we will use MATLAB for this. So for this thing, first let's open MATLAB. Okay, here we have the question, and this is MATLAB. I've minimized it so that you can see the question as well as MATLAB screen simultaneously. So now in MATLAB, let's move on to the editor window. So write edit. Let's take it a file named as lsq nonlin. Okay, lsq nonlin and our function. So I've already written the code, but I will explain it slowly so that you can understand it, what I've done actually. So first we write the C data, nothing but a C data, the C data that is given in a vector form. So 0.1, the starting data, and we actually use this colon operator so that to move forward in a specified way, like 0.1, then minus 0.01, that is 0.09, because the differences are same. All the differences are minus 0.01. So starting from 0.1, then minus, 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 and coming till 0.01, that is this point, because after this minus 0.01 would result in 0, but we don't want 0 here, we have 0.005. so we take this vector and comma the last element, and we make it into a column vector. So we take the transpose of it. See, this is transpose. So if I just, let's first comment it out, comment, and so that we are looking to both this data, let's run it. Yes, so this is my C data that is coming exactly the same, and my R data, both of these data are actually in vector form, column vector form, one column. Okay, so our data is this. Next, we can actually put a semicolon here because we don't need it to again occur. Okay, save. So initially we take a k guess value. Now we need to solve this function. So with a particular k value, we take the initial guess. So let it be 1, 1. Okay, let's uncomment it. So my initial guess of k, let it be 1, 1. So this first guy here is k1 and the second guy is k2. This is also a column vector as there is a semicolon in between them. So I have k1 and k2 both equal to 1. That is my initial guess, which I will use for further calculation. So I use a MATLAB function called lsq nonlin. Lsq nonlin. That means. So my function lsq nonlin is of this syntax, that my k solution, that the original k values that I will get, will be equal to this lsq nonlin function with its brackets. And we are solving, so this is at the rate k, we need to solve for this k value. We want this k value. K value means k1 and k2. K is a vector of k1 and k2. So we need this k value. So we'll solve at the rate k, and fun lin, this is my function. I will talk about it later. So this is my function. It is nothing but this function. We'll take it later. So k and c data and r data, the function inputs, arguments, and my initial guess. So let's see my fun lin function. So this is my fun lin function, which calculates the error, that is error is equal to fun lin, which takes it input k, c data, r data, k1 is k, the first row of k. So k is my initial guess vector. It takes the first row as k1, second row as k2, and then r, we take this, write the same formula. Don't miss out this dot operator here. Okay, if you miss out this dot operator, then everything would be wrong. Okay, because we want element by element. So this r is a vector and r data is that vector. So vector minus vector is vector. So there's an error of error. So now we move on to here. We find out the k solution, and we plot 1 by c data and 1 by r data, the original c data and r data. Then we find the k1 is k solve of 1. So this solution has two rows, 1 k1 and 1 k2. Then we plot the actual data. So let's see what it comes. So here's the data. So what we see here is that this blue line, as I've written in the code, is like this r double dash line, this dotted line is my straight line with the values that I have found out the k solve. Okay, so that it is a straight line, and 1 by c data and 1 by r data would be a straight line. This is not r data, this is r, so a straight line, and this is the actual value. let's find out the value of K solve. So K solve is coming out to be 0.8938 and 0.0040. So let's take my K1. K1 is this, and my K2 is this. Let's take out a more accurate value. So I will change the format long. I need long, more number of decimals. And let's just run it again. So a more specific value, 0.893757, and this is 0.0039. So try this thing in Excel also. You will get the K1 and K2 values. Hope you like the video. Please like, share, and subscribe.